The brother has to ask a question. Does Allah has only 99 names? Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Rabbi shrahli sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. The brother has another question. If Allah has 99 names, first of all, we have to understand that Allah does not have a 99 names. It is the names which have been compiled from the Quran and the Sahih Hadith, and the 99 names are the attributes of Allah. But this becomes as a very common, like calling these are the Allah's names, as is mentioned. I'm sure all of us read the Quran, and in the Quran there's a 99 names which has been mentioned that was compiled from Quran and the Sahih Hadith. As we can call Allah with any name. It can be a more than 99 names. It could be any name, but we should call him something which is best for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like if you read in surah Isra in verse number 110, where Allah say qul huwallahu abud rahman yamatadu falahul asmaul husna, call him Allah, call him Rahman, or whatever the name we should call him, it should be all the best names belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we can call him Allah. So we can call him we can even call him our Rabb. We can call him like he's the best. We can call him any name, but should be only for Allah. And also some of the names, and the many people contradict that, okay, these are names also belong to some human beings. We have to understand something. The qualities and the power that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, we cannot compare that to the creation. Let's say if we say this person is very merciful, and we can say that he can be a merciful, he can be a very good merciful, but we cannot compare that type of a mercy that Allah has to his creation. For an example, this is just like small planet of the world. Now all the mercy of the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been spread all over the universes. It's not a one galaxy, it's not a two galaxy, it's not a one cluster, it's not a two cluster. There are so many clusters. So Allah's mercy is being spread all over wherever the universe is being expanding and going far away. So by calling him, he's the best, and he's the only one. So we can call him anyone, but we have to call him something which is not compared to someone on the earth, or it could be to any creation. If somebody like, even not a Jibreel alayhi salam, which is the biggest creation Allah has, not even Jibreel alayhi salam. So if we can say Jibreel alayhi salam is the very best, but we cannot compare the best compared to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because still Allah is a creator and everything else is a creation. Like if you read in a chapter 112 and verse number 4, where Allah say وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ, there's nothing like unto him. And also if you read in a surah Shura, and if you read in a surah Shura verse number 11, where Allah says لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ, and similarly there are many verses that we can understand that the name that Allah has, these are the attributes of Allah, and the names and the attributes of Allah cannot be compared to the creation, because he is a creator and everything else is a creation. So Allah does not only has a 99 names, and Allah has a many names and many attributes, whatever the best belongs to him alone and nobody else.